I think this is somewhat related to the storms, if you call it natural disasters. I used to live in Columbus, Ohio. And when my son was about 5 years old, 3 or 4 years old, I used to walk with him to the daycare center to drop him off where I had a job not too far away at a nursing home. So my son's name is Henry. And he would hold my hand and we'd walk each day because we didn't have a car. We walked through different neighborhoods just for variety to see what we could see. And there was one day we walked by the fireproof warehouse and storage building, and we noticed a cute little kitten outside. And it was right beside the sidewalk. I was kind of worried. So I thought, crying out loud, and the bricks had come apart at one of the places on the corner of the building, and the little kitten had come outside. And I thought, for gosh sakes, go back in there. There's people walking by, they could be in danger. How could the cat watch it? It was sneaking out through there. And there was actually a couple of kittens there. So that was very worrisome, but I had to get on to work. So the next day, instead of walking through that same place again, I mean, instead of trying to go through different ways so we could see different scenery, we kept walking by there because we were concerned about the kitten. And so, I think it was a day or so later, I noticed that the mother cat had come out as well. And she tried to pick the kitten up, and it was kind of a little bit too big for her to carry around by this time. And so she began to carry it across the street. It was like a four-lane street. I thought, oh my gosh. Now I'm worried about the cat, the mother cat and the baby getting run over. Because she would carry it, and then it was so heavy, she had to set it down in the middle of the street. And cars were stopping, and I thought, I can't stay here in direct traffic. I'm not going to do it. So another day or so passed, and Henry and I came by again, and it was so amazing because the fireproof warehouse and storage company had burned to the ground. There was nothing there, just that little rubble that you see. And I thought, oh my gosh, I wonder if she got the other kittens out and got them across the street. And I thought, well, maybe that's why they were coming outside, because they could smell something in there, embers or something. It was just, and then it was the fireproof warehouse. I think if any place would be safe to put your stuff, it would be that. So it puzzled me a great deal. And so we continued with our other routes as we walked. And one day, a few weeks later, we were going down another street not too far away. And I saw one of those houses, this was in Columbus, Ohio, that had those little white rickrack walls underneath it because the porch was up high. And I saw some cats playing around it, some young cats, like teenage cats. And they were distinctively marked, kind of like a paint pony, blotches of black and white behind them. And I felt that I knew that those were those kittens because they were distinctively marked, and that she had found a safe place where this place looked much better. And they were playing in the grass. And so I don't have a way of knowing that for sure, but I feel sure that those were the ones, and that I was so lucky that Henry and I got to walk down that other street and see them, because if we hadn't, even to this day, I would be kind of wondering if we got out. So that's been one of my favorite stories. I hope you enjoyed it.